Like, what was it like going out there and competing against D1s, like top of the line D1s, when you were just a D2 from Colorado?
Yeah, I mean, I'd say that feeling, I did have a chip on my shoulder early on. I truly felt like, yeah, like I needed to beat these guys. Like, I, you know, but like, just because there was like talk, I know that like early on, like I got into heats that I probably shouldn't have been in. And I know that there are like D1 coaches that were like, why is this kid in there? You know, what is he doing there? And, you know, I quickly like kind of proved them wrong. I think I remember my first like 5K, like outside of a D2 meet, was at Husky, and I got third to like Chez and Pierce Murphy, who was like third at Cross that year. And I was just like, well, you know, like I'm obviously competing here. Like I belong here. And like, you know, after a while, like I just started to forget that, like I was in D2 or I was in a small school. Like I was just like, I'm going to line up and I'm going to race whoever's there. And so, yeah, like I got through that first one, and then like I kind of I got to that Mount Sac race, and then like I still had that like just a slight chip on my shoulder because like Pierce Murphy was like in that race, and I was like, well, he got me last time, so I got to get him this time. And just down the home straight kind of made it happen, and from there it was, you know, it's kind of like history. I mean, to this day, I think that's like one of my better races of college, just because like I started to forget like certain pressures. You know, I didn't really think about Division 1, Division 2. I was just like, I just love competing, and I'm gonna like compete with whoever's there.
Yeah, and it sounds like how you were saying earlier, that's kind of when you first started loving running. You know, you were kind of just out there with your dad, just not a bunch of structure, like just running, having fun. You were going to all comers with colleges and just racing. You weren't thinking about like the D1 or D2. And it's just a very interesting story, because yeah, you took such an unconventional path to your success. And I feel like at Adams, you started to like really find yourself as a runner. Would you agree with that?
Oh, definitely. Yeah, you know, I think a good chunk of that is like, was just that I redshirted my freshman year. And so I was like big. So because like at the end of high school, I was coming in, I was getting more and more high strung and more stressed about running. And then I spent a year where I just like didn't really take running seriously. I trained and like I did all that I needed to do, but I didn't race that much. And it just felt good to be like not stressed and not like high strung. And so that's kind of how I went into my next year of running. And I was just like, yeah, let's just like do what I can and like see where that takes me, you know. And it ended up being like, you know, a big jump. I think I took 47 seconds off my 5K PR in like a year, you know. And it was just because like I was just like, you know, just like sit back, like it's not the worst thing in the world if I'm not you know, an NCAA champ or a D2 champ or whatever. And like sometimes like you want it so bad that like you're the only person like kind of hindering that because you're so high strung and worked up before you even get there.
Definitely. And I feel like a lot of like top high school athletes, when they come into college, they feel that pressure to be up at the top, especially like that's a double chip. Like because I feel like you were overlooked in high school, but a part of that was just kind of like you said, you're ineligible for a little bit. So people didn't see you as much, and people were so focused on, you know, Austin running 409 as a freshman. Like, that's crazy. Yeah. Blake Haney, he had the record. He ran 412 as a freshman, you know. So you came from like California, such a crazy class. But then to go D2 on top of that, that's like two chips on each shoulder that makes you feel like you got to prove yourself to everyone.
Don't put too much dip on your chip.
Exactly. You can't have too much, you know. But yeah, no, it put me in a place where like I had to overcome that chip, and then from there I could like work up, you know. And that's just definitely something I still have to learn, is like to handle a certain pressure. And so, you know, still a learning experience right now.